darkness and the rainbow wide. That's me by eye. Whoa, 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 sweet child of mine. Oh, 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 sweet love of mine.
See, I guess I'll have to look up a good morning, won't I? Okay, chances are I'm going to butcher this one. This is Arabic. Sabah al-Khair. So it's there was a guy with an accent on there, so I kind of picked up on the Arabic accent. I actually have family that's Arabic, so I actually shouldn't actually be able to do that, but it's hard for me because, one, I have German backgrounds and we don't that much. And most of the languages I know are romantic languages and kind of do like not so I like the language, it's just very hard for me to speak. But I actually left a little bit earlier today than I had later than I had planned, so hopefully we'll get there on time. I wasn't sure how long it was gonna take me. I almost set my clock about 10 minutes before, that way I can get up a little bit earlier. My car just does not want to have any juice today. I'm trying to get up to 70 miles per hour and it just will not go. It's like, nope, not gonna do it today. I guess sometimes when you drive a hybrid, you sacrifice speed. Of course, I drove, some of you guys may have been here when I drove my Chrysler, when I first got my Chrysler. You know, I bought it for speed, I bought it for its power, I bought it for the size of it. May it got 15 miles per gallon, but I love driving the thing. I swear I did. I swear I love driving it more than I love driving this. However, I don't miss paying $60 a week for gas. I do like, however, paying $47 every 2 weeks for gas. It's nice. It really is nice. And I drive a lot, so do the math. I can drive all over the place for 2 weeks and not fill up a tank. Wearing my new boots this morning. They're comfortable. I didn't expect them to be this comfortable. They feel like tennis shoes. So, which reminds me, yes, I do have my tennis shoes in the back, so we can go to the gym this evening. So, yeah. So once I'm in the plant today, you guys won't see me until I get off now, because I don't have, I most likely won't have time or be able to get out of the plant to go to lunch, because I only get like a 30-minute lunch or something like that, and it takes like 15 minutes to get out of the plant, 15 minutes to get in the plant. So by the time you get in and out of the plant, you don't have time for lunch. So might as well just eat there, pack me a sandwich, pack ham, salami, a pepperoni, cheese, and lettuce, and some spicy mustard on honey wheat. So yeah, I make a really good sandwich. So if you guys ever want a sandwich and you're ever around me, which you probably won't be, but if you are, unless you're one of my friends and watching this, then yeah, definitely. Come talk to me. I will make you a sandwich, and you'll have one of the best sandwiches you've ever had. I make like, I don't have the nice breads that Panera Bread has, but I can make you a Panera Bread sandwich. No doubt. So, but today should be a good day. I actually get to go work with my group today. Hopefully, we'll kind of mesh together today and kind of, I won't be as shy as around them. Like, you guys know me. I'm probably really, really outgoing to you guys. But once I get around people I don't know, I kind of go, woo, and shrink and get about this tall. So I feel like I do, once I'm around them for about 2 or 3 hours, it's like I've known them for like 20 years. It just, I catch on really quick. I don't like to talk to people that much until I get to know their personality. Like I watch their personality and see and make sure that I'm not going to say anything that's going to offend someone or something like that. I like to make sure that all my grounds are covered before I start joking around and being me, because that's what I am. I'm a jokester. I like to laugh. I like to cut up, and you know, it's going to be a long day, and if you can't do that, I'm going to try to just mesh with them as much as possible. There are a lot of older guys down there, so hopefully they'll like me. Hopefully, I don't see why they wouldn't. I mean, look at me. Look at me. Just look at me. How could you not like me? I mean, honestly, I'll be honest with you. I'm not being, everybody says I'm like self-conceited and stuff because I say stuff like this, but I'm not. I'm a very likable person. I've only had like two or three people in the ever have anything against me.
Why?
Because I just don't say stuff to make people mad. And the people that were mad at me were the people I learned the mistakes from myself. But I just don't, I don't say things that'll make people mad. I try to say things that'll make people happy and things that make people like me more. I don't say anything that I don't believe in or anything like that, but I just say like fun little things, you know, it's the things that have put a smile on your face for the day. And that's what I try to do. I try to say things that'll make people smile. And if it doesn't work, screw it. So, but yeah, so hopefully today will be a good day. I gotta drive by, wave this little thing, and say, let me into the parking lot. And they'll let me in, and then I'll park and go in and scan my badge, scan my finger, run through turnstile, go through all that stuff. So, should be fun. So, I will see you guys when I get off from work. Beautiful people. Beautiful people. Hey guys, I am off from work. I am really tired. Actually got to do some stuff today. Went around cleaning and whatnot and taking out trash and mopping and whatnot. All that fun stuff. I actually found out one of my friends works there. So, guy used to, he's actually the ex-stepfather of one of my guys I graduated with. So, I ended up hanging out with him all day and going to doing everything he did. Just luckily got assigned with him, so it's pretty cool. So I'm gonna go play some basketball. I've got about 3 hours to kill here because I can't go home until 6:30 because my parents are let off bug foggers in the house, like a pesticide, and I can't go in there until 4 hours after they go off. So I'm gonna go in here and play some basketball and just hang out here for a little bit, and then I'm gonna go find something to eat later on because it's just me at home this weekend because my parents went on their anniversary thing to Gatlinburg, Tennessee, so I'm by myself this evening, so yep. So I'm gonna go play some basketball. Alrighty guys, let me preface this little section of the vlog just to say I am freaking pissed off right now. I'm cooled down a little bit. I'm just pissed off. I got kicked out of the gym today. It's complete and utter bull spit. Okay, here's what happened. I'm playing basketball all by myself. Some guys walk in, I know. Say, hey, Nate, you want to play some basketball? Yeah, I'll play some basketball. Let's play some basketball, okay? So I go down there and play some basketball. We get done with a game. I'm shooting around with them. You know, just shooting around. Nothing big. And some kid says, misses a shot and cusses out loud. The owner comes in. Kicks everyone in the gym out, and I didn't even do anything. I get kicked out of the gym because one kid opens his fat mouth and cusses. And I told him, I said, I didn't do anything. I shouldn't be getting kicked out. And I said, I was over there playing basketball by myself. They asked me to play. I play. I didn't cuss, so I shouldn't be kicked out. And he said, well, you were in the group, and you're getting kicked out. Everyone in the gym's getting kicked out. When something like this everyone gets kicked out. And I said, you know, I pay good money out of my paycheck to come down here and play. And he said, well, I don't care. I'm the owner. You're being kicked out. And I said, why should I be punished for what one person does? He said, well, sometimes when one person's actions affect everyone else. And I said, sometimes what's good for the goose isn't always good for the gander. And he didn't like that. And he said, if I didn't quit arguing, I was going to be kicked out for the rest of the year. I told him, he said, well, if you can explain to your parents why you got kicked out. And I said, I don't have to explain anything to my parents. They don't pay for my membership here.
I pay for my own membership to come down here and use this facility. And said, I said, I still don't think it's fair. And he said, oh, I don't care, I'm the owner, leave. And I said, fine. So I stormed out, slammed the door open, got halfway to my car and realized I forgot my clothes and had to go back and get my clothes. Luckily, he wasn't still standing there because that would have been really awkward. And I am fairly pissed off right now. But I can't stay long in this house because my parents set off bug foggers downstairs. That's the whole reason I was at the gym, because I didn't want to. I think I told you guys that. That's the reason I didn't want to come home so early, because the bug fogger's downstairs. So I gotta hurry up and take a shower and get out of here before I die of carbon monoxide poisoning. So I'm gonna get out of here really quick. So I'm gonna take a shower. I'll see you guys in a few. Plus, I gotta go get my phone at Sprint. I'm switching from Verizon to Sprint. Hey guys. I am in Johnson City. Just left the Sprint store. They didn't have the phone I wanted. I wanted the iPhone 5, 64 gig. I waited for like 30 minutes to get up to their desk, and then she told me they didn't have it. So I said, do you think the Best Buy has it? And she called them, and they do indeed have the phone that I want. So I'm going to go to the Best Buy and get my new phone because they have it. So I'm going to head over there. I'm starving, but I'm going to get this done before I go eat, and then I'm going to go get something to eat. I don't know where I'm going to go. Let me take myself out tonight. I don't know. We'll see. But I gotta go over here and try to pay attention to pulling out here. This is a busy intersection. Alrighty, 2 hours later. Well, close to 2 hours. About an hour and a half later in Best Buy. I'm finally out. We had a hell of a time trying to get my account set up. Their system would not accept me, and they couldn't get my phone number transferred over. So they gave me a temporary phone number, and it will switch over at 10:30 tonight. So when my cell phone stops working, the new one will start working, and I can turn it on and start using it. So, yeah. So it's not even unboxed. I get to unbox it tonight for you guys, so it should be fun. Now I've got to find something to eat, because I haven't eaten since 11 o'clock this morning, and it is 8:15. So I'm going to go find something to eat before everything in town closes. I am thinking Mexican food. Yep. Was thinking Chinese, but Mexican just hit me in the face. And she's like, hey, let's go get some Mexican. So that's what we're going to do. So I'm going to go get some Mexican food. It cost me like $380 for this phone. It was originally going to cost me $100 less. But since I had to go to Best Buy, they couldn't accept my trade-in on my phone. So, I did get the discount that I was, the other $100 discount I was going to get. I was originally going to get $200 off, but I got $100 off. I'll take that. That's what I had planned on in the first place, so I will take that any day of the week. So, let's go get some Mexican food here at this restaurant and enjoy it, every single bite of it, because I'm starving. Look how big this freaking moon is. Silly moon, it's daytime. The thing is huge. Tonight is the night I need to go take pictures of that thing, though. Definitely, because that is huge. Please don't take your love from me. I am yours forevermore. Till eternity. Silently, listen to the words I say. I'm just like Outcast, born in the trap. So what's going on with you faggots? And what you gonna do when your swagger no longer matters? And your bitch ain't the baddest, cause she in the mid-40s. And your phantom played out, so you hating on the shorties, cause they run around like they was your age, when you was your age. Fucking bitches wrong, cause now the world ain't got no A's. Yeah, 2050 on you niggas. Gold diggers sucked you dry and left them hickeys on you niggas. I used to run around like you, run the town like you, walk my red nose and clown like you. But it got old like Betty White. This rap shit real deep like Barry White. Reminiscing on the days I used to carry white. Walking through them crib hoods and them cherry nights. Now I live a berry. Alright, I'm gonna try to do this one-handed. Probably fell at it, but oh, yep, there we go. Failed at it already. Okay, come on, come in. Get him on. There we go. Got a little tab I could pull it anyway. I'm gonna just. Hey, look at that. Just so I can do this. And slide this baby open. I got a 64 gig because I use a lot of space. I don't think I'll ever use 64 gigs, but
yeah, well, I just wanted to be safe. Ooh, that is nice looking.
I haven't actually seen one brand new yet, so get this little puppy out of here. Let's place that aside. That looks really, really nice. Really nice. I'm gonna put it straight in the case. I got the spec fitted case. I've had one of these cases for every device I've owned.
Got one for my iPod 2G, got one for my iPhone 4, now I got one for my iPhone 5. I love these, they're fabric. And this one's Burton, so it's pretty cool.
Let's see what's in here. Of course, get to know dads. Wall charger, new charger. Yeah, I need to get a couple of these for the car and stuff. New headphones. I'll have to check these puppies out. I don't think there's anything under that doesn't even come out. So, what's in here? Just tell me we got stickers. Yes, we do have stickers. Sweet. That will be going on my locker at work. So, oh, this one, I need to do that tomorrow. I need to
get a locker. Come get a lock for my locker at work. So, I'm going to put this case on here.
What's my name?
You're Nathan, but you ask me to call you Big Daddy.
Thank you.
No problem.
Hey guys, so I got the vlog uploaded and all that fun stuff. Just been playing around with my new phone. I'm liking it so far. I mean, it's not a whole lot different from my other phone. I mean, it is different, but it's not a whole lot different. So, but it still takes a learning curve because it's just a slight difference. But so I'm gonna go ahead and get some sleep. I am really tired. Because one, I got up at like 5:30 this morning, and it is almost 1 o'clock in the morning. I won't sleep in the morning. And two, because I've been running around all day, had a rough day with the YMCA thing. Which I still think is ignorant as all get out. And I just don't understand his logic. His logic was faulty and fallacy. The whole thing was a fallacy. And I'm not going to get any more into that because I'm going to make myself mad again. But I'm going to go ahead and get some sleep and get ready for tomorrow. I don't know what I'm going to do tomorrow. I guess we'll find out tomorrow. We'll have to find out tomorrow, kind of. It's inevitable. So anyway, good night, guys. Peace out.